Good evening to anyone. I am Cristiano. I work here in Florence in Thales, where we develop software for the market of airports. And we use GWT as the primary technology for our user interface that we develop for our customer. We maintain a complex product which is about 270 keys of line of code, 5,000 classes, more than 200 of Maven projects, and so it is too much. We need to reduce this this level of code. We maintain this product thanks to the tools provided by the Java development environments. The user interface, which is web-based, I cannot imagine how to manage this complexity with just JavaScript. So this is the reason why we love and use GWT. Last June, at the GWT meetup, the steering committee have given indication of what will happen next on GWT 3.0 and following. And specifically, they say that some part of the framework is going to die, especially GWT user, the part of the library which includes the widgets, the GWT RPC, UI binder, etc. They've given also indication on how to survive this new release. Stick with the fundamentals, the Java core emulation, JS interop, and use third party JS framework. Okay, what can we do to prepare for this new release? Don't get panic. I think this is a really good step in the evolution of the GWT framework and the ecosystem of people who develop in Java the user interface. Okay, so I often thought to stop using GWT and start using pure JavaScript frameworks for the user interface. But no, I don't want to do this. I want to be able to reuse Java both on the web application, on the mobile platforms, and Android specifically, or iOS in the future. If we will need, we will look forward for using J2 Objective-C. And of course, I want to use Java, reuse Java on the backend. So I've made some experiment looking in this direction, and I've try to apply some recommendation which has been given by the steering committee. I've tried to apply this recommendation on a new project, not on the one we develop at work. These are studies done by myself. And I try to remove GWT user library, not to use JSNI, avoid widgets. I've used a little bit of Polymer, or better, just the polyfill part of Polymer. I've not used the integrated development environment plugins. This was not a recommendation of the steering committee, but if the evolution of GWT user is the death, then maybe the same will happen to the plugin for Eclipse and IntelliJ. And don't use GWT RPC. So let's put it into practice. I've applied this recommendation on a new application, a unit test framework, which I've developed especially for making this presentation and studying this recommendation, and I've called it WUnit. WUnit is a unit test framework for Warhammer 4000, the game. In Warhammer, it is so much difficult to test which unit is the best. For in the picture you see the Space Marine Terminator against the Gen Stealer. This requires to test this, to make statistics on which one is best, it requires to throw a lot of dice. You may eventually use the application provided by a game workshop, which make things a little bit faster, but then you have to apply all the rules by yourself, and it takes a lot of time. And then, so it came Daddy Unit. Daddy Unit is an application based on GWT and Polymer to test fast which unit is the best in a match that where two units of Warhammer fights together. Let's make a little bit demonstration. Can you hear me? So, let's take Eclipse. Let's take the WUnit web app projects. In the test sources, there is a Jet embedded server that I run as a regular Java application. This embedded Jet server is not the one I used by the provided by the GWT SDK. Sorry, it's one I've configured by myself with regular HTTP hosting options. With the attributes to run, to run the main sources of the web application from the Maven web app, but include the generated GWT code from a different path, so you have no problem in GWT Maven plugin compiling your GWT code within the web inf folder. This keep the two things separated, and as soon as you modify some of the sources on the web application and refresh the browser, the application is reloaded without need of compilation. And within this, I've started this servlet, a super dev mode servlet created by this utility, which starts together with this application, with this Jetty server, dev mode, the GWT super dev mode, published as a servlet. Let's see at what are the results of this. Let's go to Chrome, localhost. I'll open the dev JSP page. Wow. Because the port is, I'm publishing it on port 8082, sorry. As soon as I refresh the page, the servlet within the Jet embedded server recompiles the application. It is fast enough because it uses super dev mode, and the application is here. So here you have two units, one of Space Marines and one of Chaos Space Marine. Let's start the match. At first, the game simulates the start of the match. Then let's start with the first step, the first phase. Space Marines shoot, throwing the dice. Here it is the result. Then the next move is to inflict the wound. These are the rules of Warhammer. Let's run it all together and see that the winner of this match is Space Marine. So, apart from the application and the context of the application, what you see here is an example of application developed with GWT and JS Interop and web component elements made with Polyfill. Okay, let's go back to the slide. So the benchmark of WUnit are impressive. With WUnit is what it takes to test. It takes about 40 minutes for testing which unit is best. Can be verified in as far as 1 minute if you go step by step, or some millisecond if you go everything together. The application of WUnit was born in this way, with a poor data model made of poor POJOs, plain old. Why does it? Sorry, of Java made of poor POJOs, an engine developed poor in Java, and the first version was provided by a user interface developed on Java on the system out by outputting just the result of the match on the console. I want to focus on this. The codecs in the engine is the reason why I do want to still continue to use GWT, because this code is so much complex, the rules of Warhammer the game are so much complex, that I cannot imagine to develop such logic without a full object-oriented programming language. And with solid development tools like Eclipse, the refactoring of Eclipse, the test-driven approach, it is provided by integrating JUnit on your project. And so the engine was developed purely in test-driven development with a coverage of the test about 93%. The architecture aims to be cross-platform, aims to reusability. Not reusability in the common sense of one framework which develop once the single user interface for every platform, but focus on having all the parts that can be grouped together in a core, and then develop the user interfaces with the specific platform tools. That was one of the goals of Singular, as far as I've understood it aimed to. And well, I started from the console application, and when I wanted to add a user interface, as Singular was not available, I had to face with the revelation of the GWT steering committee that GWT user will not be more available in the future. And so here I will explain how I develop this application. My experiment made with using GWT without GWT user. The final architecture is developed in this way. It has been implemented in this way. The model and the engine are the same use on the console-based application. There is a presenter which is written in GWT, or maybe you may also be able to write in JavaScript by exporting with JS Interop the presenter. And the views are made in Polymer, pure Polymer, pure web web components elements. First of the recommendation, I try to remove the GWT user library from my Maven project. And it was the first failure, because GWT user includes the JS interop interfaces and the entry point interface that I cannot avoid to use. So at least I developed the project avoiding to use as much as possible from GWT user library. And at least I've been able to develop the application without the GWT user module, because I've not used anything from it, as I'm not using UI binder or anything else, just web elements and JS interop. Well, if the GWT steering committee could please split the entry point and JS interop from the main GWT user libraries, it will be a more safe migration to the next revision. Please split from the GWT user library and port into another jar for a better reuse of everyone. Then, the recommendation is don't use widgets. use Polymer. And I found it was my first experience with Polymer web components, and it's very cool. It's very expressive. Writing your elements with Polymer is very powerful technique that allows you to write elements that are extremely expressive. This is the code of an element in HTML. This WUnit element is made with the polyfill, with web components. This is the result, a row in a table, an HTML table, which is represented like this, a custom element where all the columns are your attribute you put onto the tag of your HTML custom element. And for the other columns, you include special elements. These were gear and special rules that are displayed inside these last two cells of the table. There is no time to explain you how much enthusiasm I have in being able to write element like this. This is the full implementation of an element. I've developed about 10 or 12 elements on this application. This is the implementation in Polymer, in polyfill, of the dice element, which can be green if successful, or red if the failure, or gray by default. This is the full implementation, including the random rotation is given back to the HTML element with CSS. This is another more complex element. It is the one which display the game status with the button to execute the steps of the fight and go on with the execution of the match. You can't read here, but the concept is I want to show you is that in fact the full element, including the style, CSS style, the JavaScript code to control it, and the integration to the callback, which are sent to the main engine. When I click play one, I invoke a method on the main engine. Is not that long, 82 lines of code. So, third recommendation, use JS interop. And that it is how I have integrated the elements with the GUID. So, here you find the host page of WUnit application. There are just 1, 2, 3, 4 web component elements. That's all. These elements are already working by the their behavior defined in two Polymer, but they are used from GUID. I've done this, okay. I've done this on the Java part, on GUID code. And this is how I initialize the elements on the Java application. I call a document query selector, which selects the element from their HTML ID. And in this function, I initialize them. I've written also the document query selector, and yes, this is the second fail of my test. I have to use JS and I will look forward to the next evolution of JS interop. I'm sorry, I'm using not the last, the latest one. It was too late to test the last JS interop. I will look to the next one if it is possible to write this in a more clean manner without JS and I. And this is the JS type which control this element. From Java, I can call this method setTurn to display the current turn number on this element, and all the other methods to control the view, this view which is developed with using this Polymer element. And this is how I control the output. My entry point class implement this WUnit game controller, which implement these methods to start and control the fight, and these methods are linked to the click to these buttons. Just note on the previous slide that the last method of the web component Java interface is a setter to set the callback. So the entry point class retrieve the web component interface and then set itself as the manager for the callback. Okay, fourth, don't use integrated development environment plugins. This was not one of the recommendation of the steering committee, but it is something I do like. I like the approach which is integrated into the Wicket framework, for those who know. In Wicket, as soon as you create a new project, it generates a test. In the tests of the application, an embedded Jetty server that can be launched to start with and debug it. I've hacked a little bit GWT. I've showed to you earlier some of the things, the configuration I made. I like the fact that if I need something else, I can change this class by myself because it is not some class imported from the SDK of GWT. It is a class, it is automatically generated into the test of your project. So if you need to put support for JSP, for framework like Spring or Spring Security or Spring MVC, you don't need to hack the code of GWT. You just need to work on your code of your application. And in fact, this doesn't work standalone because the code server actually in GWT is an embedded Jetty. It publishes just a servlet, but this servlet is not available for you to be used like I've used. And to make this work, I was required to make again more hacks. One more focus, I like to use the GWT single page linker, single script linker, which is one linker that produces for you just one file. The nocache.js file contains all your generated JavaScript from Java. And this doesn't work with the regular code server just because code server is published on a different port and it needs to be use XSI to be able to retrieve it. But as soon as I have hacked the code server to extract the servlet, I've been able to run everything and use the SSO linker from the same application. Again, it would be good if the steering committee make the code server more modular and reusable, so something like this doesn't require to hack the GWT code. Five recommendation. Well, don't use RPC. Well, this problem has not yet been solved because my demonstration application doesn't use communication with the server. It is all running on the browser. You don't need to. You just need to connect to the server to download the code, but then the match is computed on your JavaScript on your browser. And there is a lot of things we could do to replace GWT RPC. And I would love to still be able to use a Java interface, an asynchronous interface to communicate with the server. And there is a lot of things that we can do. But actually, I have also a solution ready, which I use on Android, but cannot work on GWT because GWT doesn't support Java Reflection, and the JSON library doesn't work on GWT. But maybe if It is more easy to hack the Java emulation of Git, maybe because it is taken out of the Git user package and exported as a standalone library. It would be more easy to hack and add things like this and add support for just the small subset of the Java reflection I need to make the previous solution work. So, some conclusion. How much of the Git user code I've used in my application? Maybe we will make the live demo later if there is time. For now, I just show you the results. If I instrument the application running with JacoCo, which is the library under the hood of Emma Coverage plugin, and I compile and then run the application, you can see that I have just only used the 8% of the Git development library. I've just for developing this application, I've just used less than 10% of the dev part of the Git SDK. And I've used 0% of Git user. In fact, this is not real because JacoCo library doesn't instrument the Java compiled to JavaScript. But we can go to the source map of your code server to check that there is only a small subset of the Git user library I've used. These are just Java emulation classes and Java emule internal and something within the Java core client. Maybe we can have a look at what inside next. So this application was built with a very minimal impact, very minimal usage of the whole Git framework. The morale is it is possible to develop application without using so much of the Git user. And the small subset of Git user that you need to use, I expect that in the next revision of Git will be ported outside of the Git user library. In the future, I would love to use Jaeger for developing such type of application. In fact, all the idea came from the idea of Singular, and I was expecting to develop this application in Singular, but in fact it has never been released up to now, so I've tried to make it what was available up to now. With Jekyll, what I've done, I expect it to be more easy, more reusable, as Jekyll will be a standalone library, a standalone module, and not the whole monolithic library Git is today. And so things will be more easy and more natural. From this is what I'm not here to promote any kind of framework, and we don't use yet this type of technologies at work. But if you would like to try it, I've opened a GitHub repository, Git Slimize, to make it slimmer, where after Git 2.8 will be released. The idea is to publish a template or maybe a Maven archetype to start developing applications like this. Just push and watch the repo because I'm not here to promote any framework, so I will develop this archetype if I'm pushed by the community, if you want it. At our company in Florence, but all over the world, Thales use Git for different products. In Florence, we use it in our team. And if you are competent in Git and developing in Java, and you are interested in working with us, have a look at the career website of our company. We have many ongoing bids that if it will be successful, we need very competent people to work with us. Well, I'm in time, almost. if you have any question, if there is a quick time for some question, feel free to ask, or you will find me hanging around here where you can ask me anything.